Welcome to tonight's contest. Here are your Rochester High School varsity player.
I'm Luke Kennedy, number 40, and I'm a forward.
Alec Garrick, senior, number 24, forward.
I'm Brandon Camp, I'm a senior, and I'm a shooting guard.
I'm Carter Screen, I'm a senior, and I play point guard.
Brett Abbott, shooting guard, sophomore.
I'm Alec Holland, I'm a sophomore and a guard.
Matthew Bastrom, senior, forward.
Dom Thomas, I'm a junior, and power forward.
Noah Dahlquist, junior, center.
I'm Taylor Medina, I'm a junior and a forward.
What kind of team you're going to have maybe from year to year, or what kind of teams you're going to play against? And this Triton team has always been somebody that's been able to battle 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A. It doesn't matter. And they've always been competitive. Beat a very good Plymouth team with Mac Mercer at the beginning of the year.
If I remember right, I looked briefly at their the results. I think they beat Culver this year as well.
Yeah, I think you're correct.
Wow.
That. Yeah.
That's saying something. Rochester and the whole Whites.
Shoots, when they shoot well, they can play with anybody.
Well, you heard Coach Reinhold saying the pregame, they could put up 30 shots from behind the arc.
Very well, and it looks like they've been shopping at the same place, University of Michigan, with neon yellow. Yeah.
Midway down low, kicks it out to Andrew Zistri on the way, and a long rebound to Holland. He loses it to a floating Sellers. His jump in the lane is good, and Triton strikes first, and a man-to-man press. Actually, probably a 2-2-1 zone press. Yep.
2-2-1, yep.
And then Holland throws it behind a cutting Kennedy, and it'll go back to Triton.
Two turnovers so far in the first 30 seconds for the Zebras. Got to cut that number down, because if you're going to shoot threes, one of the ways to get threes are in transition and layups, and you don't want to get into that style of game.
Sellers will bring it through the center circle. Work to the right side against Holland. Bounce pass to Midway. He holds against Kennedy. Top to Shepherd. Enter Shepherd right side. Now down low to Quarter. Quarter on the baseline against Basham. Gives right side to Andrews. I'm sorry, to Shepherd. Shepherd down low to Quarter. Quarter against Basham. Backs his way and throws up a shot off the window. It's good. I'd say they better get a different matchup on Quarter. Basham gives up about 5 inches, and Quarter's going to make him pay.
That's where Medina would have made a difference, because that would have been his assignment.
Turnover, Rochester. Quarter has it left side of the floor. Now middle of the floor, slows up, resets, gives to Shepherd in the corner to Riker. His three is good. Timeout, Rochester at the 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
The Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
6:40 to play in the first quarter. Triton out to a 7-0 lead, and here comes the half-court trap, and then Shepherd shoulder blocks Garrick, and it'll be a foul on Triton.
First of the game, Triton showed a 2-3 zone until the Zebras got across half court, and then two defenders sped at Carter Screeton trying to get him to read and make a quick pass and try to read his eyes and get a turnover.
And they just about hit it.
Yep.
Screeton, left side, in the corner to Basham. Basham on the block, out to Kennedy, top of the key, right side to Garrick. Looks at a three, now kicks it out to Screeton, left wing. Screeton drives, jump pass down to Basham. Basham shot on the way, no good. Rebound tipped around, Holland comes out of there with it. He steps back for a three, it's good!
Holland has back-to-back game in double figures. He shot the three ball well. It's good to see a good start.
Didn't even hesitate.
Yep.
And I like to see that. Shepherd, right side to Sellers. Sellers around the defense and carries the basketball. Rochester going to get it back after an unforced turnover.
Okay.
6 minutes to play in the first quarter, 7-3, Rochester. I'm sorry, Triton. Triton through the center circle, now works to the left side. 2-3 zone by Triton.
I think Triton maybe botched back man-to-man.
Okay. Well, I'd eventually gotten to man-to-man if you just give me a little opportunity. Garrick around the defense to Streeton right side. Streeton travels.
if you could figure out some of the stuff we were doing this year. It took you a few minutes.
I couldn't. I gave Brad about three or four or five different options, different choices for him to pick one, and we blindly chose, and sometimes we were right. 7-3, it's right, and they've got the basketball going to our right.
He was in a trapping 2-3.
Okay. Right. Reichert loses the basketball screen, has it run, gives it ahead to Garrick. Garrick, right hand, a layup is good to the foul. As that thing, the ball hung on the rim for a second or two, and it finally fell through.
Nice job, pass ahead, okay? Instead of trying to take it your own on the dribble to get that pass and thread the needle, nice look and good job by Garrick to be ready for the catch and to finish through contact.
Yeah, led him nicely. Garrick for one, looking to cut this lead to one. Free throw for the seniors, no good. Ball being tipped around, Basham had his fingers on it. But quickly, Triton has it. Reichert for three, wide open, off the mark, no good. Offensive rebound to Sellers, loses it out of bounds, and it's going to go back to Rochester.
Triton's going to put the press back on. Looks like they're going to go back into their 2-2-1.
Quarter, who is the shooter for Triton, is holding his right thumb. Must have got that jammed a little bit. Kennedy around the defense, right wing, high on the right side to Garrick. 7-5. Triton. Garrick gets a double team to Street, and wide open in the corner to Holland, begging for the basketball. Shoot the three. Good again. Might want a guard, number three. 8-7, Rochester. Shepard in the left wing. Dribbles away from the double team. Now to Reichert, high on the right side to Quarter, who directs traffic on the wing. Outside to Sellers. Sellers dribbles one time. Top over the top of the defense to Quarter. Now left side to Reichert. Baseline to Shepard. He's fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Nice little short corner move by Triton. Guy on the block just stepped off a couple steps off the block in the person at the high post just dove down to the block. Nice give and go by Triton. To the foul on Howland, his first, team's first.
4:38 to play in the first quarter. Rochester on an 8-0 run. Triton started this game on a 7-0 run.
That's a big foul. Howland cannot afford his second foul here. He's got to play the rest of the half. They need him on the floor. He's come out aggressively here these last few games. He's come out and knocked down a couple threes already. They need to keep him on the floor.
First free throw by Shepard is good. He'll have one more. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Second one for Shepard is good again. Triton back up 9-8. And again, it'll be in a half-court trap. Garrick crosses the timeline. He gets a triple team to Kennedy. He'll fire his own three. It's in and out, no good. Basham with the rebound. A put back on the way, no good, but a foul coming on Triton. And Matt Basham will go to the line to shoot two.
I think that's one of the ways Basham's in the lineup. He's just been a scrappy player making heads-up hustle plays, and that's another example. Undersized, but working really hard underneath.
Yeah, I was going to say, he makes up for his lack of height by just hustling and banging down low, and he's got pretty good jumping ability to make up for that 5'10 frame. Free throw by Basham is good. We're tied at 9. 4:25 to play in the first quarter, tied at 9. Again, Rochester without Taylor Medina tonight. Suffered a foot injury last night. Probably will be out this week. Definitely the first two this week. Second one by Basham is good again. 10-9, Rochester. 4:20 to play in the first quarter, trying to the basketball. 2-1-2. Oh, boy. Sellers travels. Going to give it back to Rochester.
You know, credit to Zebras. Coach Reinhold had to burn a quick timeout, I think, to get a little attitude adjustment, and the guys have responded and have stormed back to take the lead.
So Rochester will have it after the Triton turnover. And into the game for the first time will be Yo. And also coming in for Triton will be Jordan Anderson.
Along with number 10, Darren Harrell.
4:19 to play in the first quarter. Rochester by one.
Triton gets a little smaller with this rotation.
Yeah.
And go back to man-to-man defense.
Garrick, bounce pass top the key to Holland. Holland fakes, gives it out to Streeton. Streeton in the lane. Kennedy, he fakes a three and travels.
Fourth turnover by the Zebras, but credit Kennedy. He's getting a lot of attention as he's been able to knock down that shot, trying to set up the drive, just shuffled his feet before he put the ball on the floor. Zebras, a little token pressure.
Anderson to the backcourt. Gives the Quarter, crosses the timeline left, jumps over the double team in the corner to Harrell, who's in the basketball game for the first time, to Anderson. Anderson to Shepard, high on the left side, now in the corner to Quarter. Quarter, right wing pass to Harrell. His three is no good. Offensive rebound by Shepard. Gives it outside to Anderson. He'll fire a three. It's good. Jordan Anderson, a sophomore for Triton, buries a three and puts Triton up by two. Straighten around the defense to Garrick. Rochester yet to cross the timeline. Finally does high on the right side over the defense to Straighten. Back to Garrick on the right wing. Garrick holds over the top of the defense to Straighten. Quickly to Kennedy, the free throw line. Luke holds. Gives down low. Ball is blocked away. It's loose. Triton picks it up. Now ahead to Anderson. Anderson left side to Shepard. Fakes a three. Drives it. Nice defense by Garrick. Cut off. And now a steal by Basham. Basham will go in for the before the shot. We're going to have a foul. Oh, my good gracious. That's going to be a foul. The bucket will be good, and the free throw. I get the foul, but, man, there are some kids, there are some guys in the NBA would love that continuation.
Haven't seen that kind of call since Kobe's been on the sideline. We'll take it.
Basham with one to try to complete the three-point play. He cannot rebound to Shepard. Now quickly to Jackson and make that Anderson, I beg your pardon.
He's back in a 2-3.
Anderson holds now to Harrell high on the right side. Anderson between the rings. Anderson in the center circle. Back to Harrell high on the right side to Anderson. Quickly left side to Shepard. Back to Anderson top of the key. Right side to Harrell. Harrell back to Anderson. Quickly to Shepard. Shepard behind the arc. Over the top of the defense to Anderson. He'll fire another three. It's good again. Nothing but the bottom of the net. And now tightened up by three at 15-12. 2.5 to play. First quarter. Holland to Garrick. Stands in the center circle. Left side to Straighten. Straighten to Kennedy. Fakes a shot. Drives it to the elbow to Basham. Basham down low to Kennedy. Turnaround jumper in the paint is on the way. In and out. No good. And the rebound to Yo. Mason Yo gives to Anderson. Triton run. Right side to Harrell. Harrell in the corner to, oh, Anderson. He had a wide open opportunity. Saves him. Pass it up.
Yeah, this zone of Zebras in. Got to be a little more extension. Good quick reversal. Triton's getting wide open looks.
Quarter. Quickly, Anderson on the right wing. Back to quarter, top of the key. Now Anderson will back it out and reset for Triton with 1:50 to play in the first quarter. 15-12, Triton. Harrell gives it to Yo, and he travels. Dominic Thomas comes into the game for the first time, and Basham gets a well-deserved rest.
Number 33.
Both teams a little sluggish here offensively at the start, or maybe out of control. Zebras have five turnovers. That's the fourth on Triton with 1:47 left in the first.
And Triton up by three. Quickly to Kennedy, high on the left side against Yo. To Garrick. Garrick pushes away in the lane. He throws up a shot. It's good. Now Rochester within one with 90 seconds to play in the first quarter. Sellers back in the game. Gives to Anderson. Now right side to Harrell. Back to Anderson. Back to Harrell on the right wing behind the arc. Over the top of the defense to Anderson. Quickly swings it the other way to Reichert. To Anderson, back to Riker, left side. He'll fire a three from the wing. It's short. Don Thomas with the rebound. He gives to Holland. A minute 10 to play in the first quarter. Rochester down by one. Holland, three, left wing. Good! Rochester up by two. 60 seconds to play, first quarter.
Third three of the quarter for Holland.
Good for him. No hesitation at all in that. Yo at the right elbow. One dribble outside to Anderson. He'll fire another three. No good off the back of the iron. Rebound, though, by Sellers and Triton. And we're going to have a foul down low on the Zebras.
Can't quite tell. Maybe Garrick coming down after the rebound. Yes. Foul's going to be on Garrick. His first. Team second.
Brandon Camp comes into the game for the first time. And Streeton will sit down. 47.9 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 17-15. Harrell gets the inbounds pass from Anderson. Gives it back to Anderson. He goes top of the key. Man-to-man defense. Right side to Harrell. Harrell bounce pass from the baseline to Sellers. And his pass is stolen by Kennedy. Luke now gives to Camp. Rochester wins at 32. Camp up by two. Jump stop. Kicks it outside to Kennedy. Fakes a three. Now holds behind the arc. Gives to Camp top of the key. He's got 25 seconds.
I think the Zebras may try to hold for the last shot.
I think they should.
Big confidence boost if he can take a lead into the second quarter.
Holland works against Harrell to Kennedy with 15. Bounce pass to Garrick with 13. Garrick drives into the basket hard. Full away jumper off the window. He's going to foul.
6 point for Garrick. Foul's going to be on number 33, Skyler Reichert, his first, team's fifth. So Zebras are doing a couple things. They're being aggressive, and they're getting Triton in foul trouble. The fifth team foul of the quarter for Triton. Garrick going to the line where he has missed his only attempt thus far, but makes that one. So Garrick has seven in the
Rochester's
quarter.
Playing a very good first quarter. Probably the most points they've scored in the first quarter all year. Anderson with three. Outside to Reichert with one. The jumper at the buzzer is no good. After one, Rochester leads by five. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Second quarter we go here at Rochester High School. Rochester up 20-15. And for, well, the second game out of the last three, Rochester's put 20 up in a quarter.
Yeah, let's hope this is better than Wabash, because last time they put 20 was the second quarter against Wabash, and they came back with a two-point third. So I'm sure Coach reminded them, they've done an excellent job, attacked the basket, good spacing, good movement, knocked down. Holland's knocked down the threes when they've been there. You know, they were down 7-0 about 90 seconds in and came back and outscored them 20-8 from that point on. So
Holland on fire from the floor. He kicks it out to Basham, who's back in the game. Now that Brett Abbott, who's in the game for the first time. Holland fakes the three. Harrell right in his jersey. Out to Camp. Camp on the wing. Drives it to the elbow. Kicks it in the corner to Kennedy. Back to Camp. Camp drives it inside the three-point line. Out to Kennedy. Three in the right wing. Short. And the rebound to Holland. Holland is ran over by Kennedy. Loses the basketball. Now out to Camp. Camp in the paint. To Basham. He drives the baseline. Cut off by the defense and loses out of bounds. Okay, this is what I saw there. We did not score. However, Luke Kennedy shot a three and followed it. Did you notice that?
Followed the shot, being really aggressive. And Holland came in to rebound, too, from the guard spot. That's little extra effort plays that go a long way.
20-15, Rochester. Harrell still in the basketball game against Basham. Gives to Shepherd on the right wing. Looking down the quarter. Good, nice defense by Camp. Down to Midway.
Zebras back in man-to-man, trying to mix up their defenses, I think, just trying to get Triton a little uncomfortable.
Harrell for three over Basham, no good, but we're going to have a push-off foul on quarter, and Rochester going to get it back.
And that's going to be that young man's second, team six, so another good positive sign for the Zebras. Hopefully, the shooting free throws the rest of the half. In order for that to be important, got to continue to attack the basket. I know Holland hit some threes, but, you know, Luke's 0 for 2 from out there, and you want to make sure shots are coming from within in the rhythm of the offense, but continue to attack the basket.
But, and I think the last couple of threes have come from that. So do you keep shooting or do you change it up?
Well, you know, Holland's going to get a lot more of attention. I'm sure Coach Grove went into that first quarter timeout and said, hey, we got to make sure we know where Holland's at all times. But everybody else is going to have to, you know, drives, post feeds, get the ball inside if you can.
Holland is out of the game now. Streeting back in. And he has the top of the key. Right side to Camp. Camp drives it right. Goes to the basket hard. Throws up a shot. It's no good off the mark. And the rebound to Harrell. And Harrell has got to step out. Yeah. Steps on the end line out of bounds. I like it. Camp drove to the basket hard in the intention of going to the glass and scoring. He just missed it. I like it.
That was a nice move. He got a little more towards the side. You would like him maybe keep an angle and use the backboard. Don't have to finesse it as much. But it's still a good idea of Camp to go to the basket.
Abbott to Camp. Camp loses it. There's a scramble for it. And we're going to have a tie up and Trent going to get it. 6.5 to play, first half. Rochester up by 5 at 20-15. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Trident with the basketball going to our right.
Pretty small lineup by the Zebras, trying to match the smaller lineup for Triton. Garrett, the tallest player on the floor for the Z's.
2-3 zone right now for the Rochester defense. Harrell over the top to Anderson, quickly left side to Sellers on the corner. To Midway, down low to Shepherd, and he is fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Triton's done a good job. It's a 1-3-1 type of offense where the guy at the bottom is kind of a baseline runner, goes to the corner, and then the middle just flashes to the block. They've gotten that look a couple times. Zebras have fouled on both occasions. That's Garrick's second, team's third.
24, Tanner Shepherd.
Tanner Shepherd at the line to shoot two for Triton. First one is good for the lefty. He'll have one more. Valley product once upon a time, I believe.
Yes, you'd be correct. Speaking of Valley, their game with Bremen postponed till tomorrow.
Okay.
Not many games in the area tonight. Probably weather related.
Yeah. But had a great night to drive there. 43 degrees will get rid of a lot of snow and ice on the road.
We've had winter and spring in the last 12 hours.
Abbott drives it to the elbow. Gives to Gehrig. On the baseline now is Alec Gehrig. Trying to back his way in. Spinner on the way off the baseline is no good. Ball being tipped around. Trent comes out of there with it. Now Abbott has it. Abbott out to Streeton. Streeton now gives top of the key to Camp, and he travels. Trenton fans getting a little bit edgy, thinking about Rochester having getting away with the fouls.
And number three, Alley.
Turnover for Rochester, six for Triton.
Number 33, Skyler.
But the Zebras are hanging in. I mean, some of those are trying to make plays.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes the coach will take mistakes of aggression versus mistakes of panicking, and the Zebras are making aggressive mistakes.
Three-point lead for the Zebras right now. Holland just about picks a pocket of Sellers. He has it left side. Playing with one foul. You got to be careful.
Mm-hmm.
Ball tipped down low to Shepherd. Shepherd throws up a prayer. It's no good. Ball being tipped around. Holland comes out of there with it. Holly now runs for Rochester through the center circle, works high to the right side, now near side to Streeton. Streeton fakes left, drives right, leaner in the lane, no good. Rebound to Triton, and we're going to have a foul on Streeton.
Something we've seen a little bit here this year from the Zebras is frustration fouls. Drive in, try to make something happen, it doesn't, and over the back call.
Rochester will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Just as coaches and team players need to have excellent communication skills to win games, so do you when it comes to all of your telecommunication needs. At RTC, they strive to bring you the very latest technology when it comes to telephone, high-speed internet, and cable television. Call them at 223-2191 and ask to speak with one of their knowledgeable, helpful, and local customer service representatives. RTC, local products, local support. Or local investment.
Zebra Basketball. WROI.
5:24 to play in the first half. Rochester up 20-17. And we've already kind of fell into that. Well, we're going to that direction of the Wabash direction where they scored 20 in the second quarter, came back in the third, and 7-10 went by in the third quarter in that game. They only scored a bucket in the entire quarter. We're going that direction right now.
But the good news is we've only given up two, so it's not as big of an impact because you still have a lead. And Zebra's trying to mix up their defenses here, a little bit of a full court, or three-quarters court to a half-court trap, maybe trying to turn some defense into offense.
So Rochester makes that Triton with the basketball right in front of the Rochester bench. Reichert directs traffic, looking to get it in, and it does so to Sellers. Sellers then is called for over and back. I'm not sure what happened there, Stays. Did he bang that off the leg of somebody?
I don't know exactly what happened. Went back that far.
He stepped on it. He stepped on the line. 5:10 to play in the first half. Rochester up 20-17. The screen with the basketball going to our left. Kennedy high on the right side, the baseline to Holland. Holland back to Kennedy on the right wing. Now swings the left side to Basham in the corner to Streeton. Man-to-man defense by Triton. Streeton to Holland. His three partially blocked. Picked up by Shepherd. Shepherd on the way for Triton. Crossover dribble goes to the basket. Shot on the way is no good, but a foul coming on the Zebras. And Shepherd will go back to the line to shoot two.
That foul's going to be on Abbott.
Zebra ball.
That's going to be his first, team's fifth. And Shepherd's going to go to the line where he's already 4-for-4.
He's been there three times, or this will be his third time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
4-for-4 already.
Tanner Shepherd at the line to shoot two shots for Triton. Eyes the first one, lets it fly. It's good again. And he has one more to look to cut this Rochester lead to one with 4:52 to play in the first half.
He's got all three Triton points off from the free throw line. Make it four.
Second by Shepherd is good. 20-19 Rochester. 4:45 to play in the first half. Creighton passes to Holland, drives it left in the paint, kicks it out to Kennedy. Luke, couple of dribbles to Streeton, top of the key between the rings. Streeton, right side to Abbott, drives the baseline. Abbott cut off by the defense, now to Basham, quickly to Holland in the center circle. Now to Streeton. Abbott fakes right, drives it left, out to Kennedy. Kennedy in the paint, cut off by the defense, feeds down low to Basham. Basham has his pass tipped away and stolen by Meadway, and then Rochester tries to steal it back, but Triton keeps possession. Right side to Reichert, cut off by the double team on the baseline. Over the top of the defense for to Shepherd. His three is in and out, no good. Kennedy with the rebound. Down the street, and Rochester runs up by a point with 4 minutes to play in the first half.
Rochester Middle School basketball.
Right side to Basham, behind the arc, about 5 feet. Gives to Holland. A tough pass to handle. Basham gets it back, now to Holland. Left side to Street. Carter drives it right, in the paint, out to Kennedy. Three, right baseline, in and out, no good. And Basham just picked up another foul. Good look, that was within the offense, yes?
Yeah, good look within the offense. It runs some clock. Just Wells run a little dry here again. We've played 4 minutes and 19 seconds. Zebras yet to hit the scoreboard here in the second quarter. And Basham's first, team six. So both teams will be shooting free throws the rest of the half.
3:35 to play in the first half. Rochester by one. Anderson across the timeline. Over the top of the defense to Sellers. Sellers left side. Now bounce pass to the near side to Anderson. Anderson against the 2-3 zone stays. Extended out to the volleyball line.
Yep.
Sellers stays from going out of bounds. And has his pass almost stolen. Now it is by Abbott. Abbott. And then has his pass stolen by Shepherd. Nice job by Shepherd following that play. And he brings it up to four. No look pass to Reichert for three. Right corner's good. And Triton regains the lead at 22-20. Holland quickly down the floor for Rochester. Kennedy top of the key. Luke to Streeton high on the right side. Streeton gets Reichert, gives to Holland. Holland behind the arc, top of the key to Abbott, and he travels.
Tenth turnover of the half for the Zebras.
Back in with the trophies, number 20.
Yo will come back in for Triton, and Camp will come back in for the Zebras. 2:55 to play, first half. Right now up 22-20. And Rochester will be in a 2-3 zone. And Anderson will bring it up.
Yeah, they need to extend a little bit. In first quarter, they kind of packed in a little too much and gave too many open looks. You got to come out and extend it, get out on the shooters. As Camp commits his first foul, team seventh.
Zebra foul.
And that'll send Skyler Reichert to the line to shoot one in the bonus for the Triton Trojans.
Reichert has not been to the line yet. He has hit two threes thus far.
Reichert's first one is good. I've got a feeling these kids do this a lot. One more coming for the junior Reichert. Eyes a second one, lets it fly, it's good again. 24-20, Brighton on top. They're on a 9-0 run right now here in the second quarter.
Triton also a perfect 8-for-8 from the line as a team.
That helps. As you well know,
Heber's not bad, 3-for-5.
Stays, we got some lights flickering here. As Camp throws up a shot, it's no good. Anderson with the rebound, behind his back dribble. Keeps the possession up, and ahead to Shepherd. Now in the corner to Reichert, quick three over Kennedy. Good! All of a sudden, Triton is out to a 7-point lead with 2:10 to play in the first half.
Here we are again. The Zebras still haven't scored. We're inside just right at 2 minutes left. They've gone a 6-minute scoring drought.
Rochester was up 20-15 after one. Kennedy quickly to Basham in the corner to Holland. Holland with Anderson in his jersey gives back to Camp high on the right side. Camp drives it left, now to Kennedy. Luke against Meadway, has his pocket pick. Meadway picks it up. He'll go in for the right-handed layup. It's no good, but a foul coming on Kennedy, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, the good news about that foul is it's Luke's first, so he made it almost through the entire first half without committing a foul.
At the line.
Zebra's eighth, however, but shooting foul anyway, so Meadway is going to go to the line for two.
Meadway for two, first one of the way is good, nothing but net. Meadway is a 6'2 senior for Triton, and he'll have one more looking to push this lead to 9 with a minute 45 to play in the first half.
With that free throw, all 5 Triton starters have scored now.
Second one's good again. Now, Coach Grove's been there a while. Yeah. He knows what's going on.
Triton said 6 players scored. Zebras only Holland, Garrig, and Basham. Only 3 that have scored at this point.
And no Kennedy.
Right.
Holland drives it left. Pull-up jumper just inside. The arc, it goes.
Zebra basket, number 3.
And the lead is cut to 7 with a minute 25 to play in the first half. Down low to Meadway to a cutting Yo. Jumper over Kennedy. No good. Ball being kicked around. Holland comes out of there with it. Gives it ahead to Camp. Camp, right side. Stump jump stop, rises up, shot blocked. Fashion there, pick it up. Fashion's put back off the window too hard. And Yo with it. Yo has a stolen by Basham and out of bounds by Rochester. We'll go to Triton. Yep.
Great hustle play by Basham. Wow, he made a couple plays, one to keep it alive and get an offensive rebound, and another one to lay out and try to keep that ball in. Looked like he could have had a foul on Triton. The kid hip-checked Basham as he was diving for it. Could have easily been a foul call on Triton. Don't think the referee had a great angle to see that, but we could from our vantage point. And so Triton will inbound it. Zebra's looking to pick up pressure maybe a little bit, maybe a little 2-1-2.
So it's a minute to play in the first half. Rochester down by 7. Woo. Harrell got away with a carry or double dribble there. Is that pass all the way to Anderson? Anderson has it at the elbow. Kicks it out to Harrell. Now quickly in the right corner to Reichner. Another quick three off the mark. No good. But an offensive rebound to Shepard. Shepard, spinner shot all the way. No good. Kennedy will pick up foul number 2. And again, Tanner Shepard will go to the line to shoot 2 for Triton.
Yep. Luke spent most of the first half able to stay out of foul trouble, and now he's got 2 in the last minute.
43 and a half seconds to play.
Shepard.
And the second quarter, and Shepard connects on his first one.
Perfect 7-for-7 from the line for Mr. Shepard. All of his points have been from the line.
And Triton back up by 8. One more coming for Shepard, the senior. Second one's good again. 40 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester down by 9. Screen across the timeline. Just inside the 10-second line. Dribbles the basketball. We're down to 30. Drives it right. Now high on the right side to Camp with 28. Camp around the defense. Kicks it out to Holland with 25. Holland holds with 23. Holland drives it right with 22. In the paint out to Kennedy with 20. He passes up the shot to Street now with 15. Street drives it left to Camp with 14. Camp a couple of dribbles to the right. Now to Screeton left side with 10. Middle of the floor now to Screeton with 7. Works to the right wing with 6. Left side to Kennedy with 5. Kennedy drives it right with 3. Sets down low to Camp. Her shot blocked at the buzzer. At halftime, Triton leads by 9, 31-22. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle. RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC. We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Third quarter at Rochester High School. The Zebras trail by 9 as they get the ball first going to our right. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Holland has it at the volleyball line high on the left side against Shepard as that 2-3 zone extended to the volleyball line. Now to Gehrig, who's been awfully quiet in this game as well.
I think it's actually man-to-man just by the way the Zebras are lined up. It looks like a zone, but it looks like they're still following their guys through the lane.
Kennedy to Gehrig, high on the left side to Street. So they're saying, shoot it. We'll let you take that 19-20 footer, and then we'll come out to guard you if you can hit it.
Right, right. And that's the cushion of having a 9-point lead.
Streeton behind the arc of the right side against Anderson. Drives it right in the lane now out to Holland. Ooh, got away with the travel, yep.
Luke still hasn't left the 3-point line.
He gets it now in the right corner. Where she gets quarter. Outside to Gehrig. Gehrig drives it. Leaner.
Oh.
Foul on Gehrig.
That's a reach.
That is three, unfortunately. Nice job. I think he did the right thing. I think the defender was sliding underneath, and I think in the state of Indiana last week, the officials have gotten together and said, let's make more charge calls. I think these referees got that memo as well.
Anderson drives it right. Turnaround jumper for Shepard is no good. Offensive rebound for Shepard. He's fouled on the putback. He'll go to the line to shoot two. 9-point lead for the Triton Trojans, and Shepard, who has perfect tonight at the free throw line, goes there for two.
Their entire team's perfect from the line tonight. Maybe halftime cooled them off.
Let's hope.
Not so much.
10-point lead now for Triton. One more coming for the senior, Tanner Shepard. Second one on the way is good again. 33-22.
A lot of times this is where you see the Zebras maybe get out of character and rush some shots and get some quick shots trying to get it all back at once.
There's a turnover. Shepard goes to the basket, left-handed layup, no good. And the rebound to Gehrig. Gehrig drives it down the middle of the floor. No look pass to Kennedy. Three left baseline for the Zebras. It's off the mark, no good. Ball tipped around. It's going to be tied. Actually, Holland has it now. Alec Holland comes out of there with it. Fakes the three, top to Streeton. 33-22, Rochester. After the first quarter, they're on, Triton that is, on an 18-2 run. Streeton on the right wing, drives it left, in the paint, cut off by Anderson, out to Gehrig. Gehrig holds above his head, drives it down low, kicks it out to Streeton. Streeton on the wing, left side to Holland. Holland, three over Shepard. Off the mark, no good. Kennedy the rebound. And now we're going to reach in on Anderson.
Good to see Luke hit the boards. It's going to be Anderson second, team's first. Zebras being pretty patient. That's a good sign. Just got to get something on the other end.
Yeah, about behind the arc. That's about all that's happening now. Garrett goes hard to the rack. Blocked by Quarter. Ball being tipped away. Shepard has it. Shepard, right side of the floor, will go in and put it up for his right hand. And it's 35-22. And Coach Reinhold will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
The next time you buy a cart full of groceries, make a car payment, or write that big mortgage check, ask yourself, what would my family do if I wasn't there to buy those groceries? Or make that car payment, or write that check. If you didn't like the answer, ask a State Farm agent about life insurance and start getting some answers you will like. Welcome to that place where doing it for them meets doing it today. Get started by contacting State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017.
It's just nonsense the way some water softener companies claim electricity is the only thing that matters when it comes to better water. Culligan embraces technology. Their water softeners use $3 a year in electricity. That $3 a year powers their smart sensor, the brain of the softener, so it recharges only when needed. That means you don't waste salt or water the way brainless non-electric softeners do. Start saving today by calling Culligan of Fulton County, 574-223-2420, and trying the smarter solution to hard water for only $10 a month. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
5:36 to play in the third quarter. 35-22, the Zebras trail the Triton Trojans here at home, and Rochester will have it after their timeout going to our right. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Guys are on the road on Friday and Saturday this week. Friday they go to Peru to battle the Tigers, and Saturday at Manchester to make up game in the TRC. Kennedy feeds down low to Gehrig. Gehrig backs his way in, loses the handle, picks it up in the paint, out to Kennedy. Kennedy drives it down low, out to Streeton. Streeton top the key to Gehrig. Gehrig with the basketball to Basham in the left block. Gives right elbow to Holland. His pass, or his shot, is blocked. Shepard has it, hesitates, goes to the basket, throws it, runs over Basham. No call either way. Holland with the rebound. Holland runs it up the floor. Fakes a pass. Shot no good. Gehrig with the rebound. Loses the handle. Ball loose, still loose from the floor. And Triton's going to knock it out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester.
Oh,
it's going to be last touch by Rochester. It'll go back to Triton. What? There was three Triton Trojans around the basketball. How is that possible?
Yeah. None of the other guys are going to help because none of the other two officials even made it past half court. So that was a call on his own. And
I guess he's standing right over it, but there's a lot more opportunities for blue to touch that than white.
Yeah, absolutely. What did you always say? Just because you're the closest guy at Riker for three, good. Just because you're the closest one, too, it doesn't mean you see it that well. 38-22. Garrick on the right elbow. Gives it top to Streeton. Streeton drives it right out to Holland. Holland in the paint. Rises up over the defense. Blocked by Reichert. Now to Shepard. Shepard right side of the floor. Goes to the basket. His shot is blocked by Kennedy. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
He should have tried to take a charge. Probably would have got the call. Just by the way it's been going. But that's unfortunately going to be Luke's third. Team's third. And Hannah Shepard's going to the line. He's already got 12 on the night.
How many from the line?
Make it 13, all but two.
Noah Dahlquist comes into the game. He had a fantastic game in the JV contest. He went for 15 for the Zebras. So Kennedy and Basham comes out, and Abbott and Dahlquist comes in.
See if Dahlquist can't do some work on the blocks. I don't think you'll see him hanging out. Outside, maybe he can scrap and get some inside garbage points.
Shepard, good again. 40-22. Brighton on top. Rochester yet to score in this half. Abbott fakes right, drives it left in the paint, leaner on the waist. Tough shot, rebound by Corner. Shot no good, Brighton run. Corner, middle of the floor. Leaner in the paint is no good, and the rebound tipped around. Dahlquist comes out of there with it. Dahlquist now ahead to Holland. Holland fakes the three, now to Streeton. Streeton drives it left. Gives to Dahlquist on the baseline. Over the top of the defense to Holland on the wing. Now right side to Gehrig. Gehrig around the pick. Pull-up jumper from 18 feet is good.
Good-looking shot by Gehrig. In rhythm. Pull-up jumper.
40-24.
Zebras have 4 points now since the start of the second quarter.
Feed away. Shepard to Corner. Corner over the top of the defense to Reichert. Wide open three. Good again. Good heaven. He's hit four or five of those already tonight.
That's his fifth three. He's got 17.
And the lead is 19 for Triton. Abbott at the elbow left. Out to Garrick. Drives it down to the block. He throws up a shot at the glass. It's good again. Triton on a jog. Brings it across the timeline. Going to our left with 3:10 to play in the third. Out to Corner. Corner drives the baseline, throws up a shot, it's good. Drove right around the street and went to the rack and then kind of gives one of those grins down the floor. I guess it's going to be tough to stop me. Street and holds, left wing. Down low to Dahlquist. Noah, give it go. Back to Street, it's good. Great look by Noah Dahlquist. Good finish by Street.
Nice job by the big man.
45-28. Brighton on top. Anderson drives it left and travels. I think he was expecting Shepard to go back door before he got to the end of his steps.
Sellers, number 20.
Sellers, Yo, Harrell is back into the game for Triton. Rochester will have it going to our right. 2:40 to play in the third. 45-28. Triton on top. Streeton. Left side against Anderson. Now to Gehrig. Gehrig fakes a shot, drives it. He's fouled before he gets there. And it'll be out of bounds to the Zebras. Baseline right, 2:26 to play in the third quarter.
Sellers, first team, second.
Abbott will look to trigger it in, baseline right. Brett looks. Bounce pass into Gehrig. Long three for the Zebras. Short. And the rebound to Sellers. Good block out for Triton. Sellers hesitates. Now accelerates across the timeline. Works right side to Shepard. Now to a wide open Harrell. His three is good. And I'm telling you, Stays, most of these threes are wide open.
8-3-pointer of the game for Triton.
It's a 20-point lead now for the Trojans as Holland has it. His floater in the lane off the window and good.
Number three.
Alec Holland has two more.
13 for the game.
Just for him. A minute third, 50 to play.
Third straight in doubles. That's we talk about finding some positive. That's
yep,
definitely
absolutely.
One. He's got that mode of where he's looking for a shot now.
Sellers. Couple of dribbles out to Yo. Gives to Shepard. Now left side to Anderson. Anderson for Triton with the basketball. Works to the top of the key to Harrell with a minute 30 to play. in the third. Shepard backs his way in, throws up his shot. It's no good. In and out, gets his own rebound, the putback. Good, and a foul. Noah Dahlquist picks up his first foul of the game, and Anders will go make that. Shepard will go to the line to shoot one.
Number 54, Noah Dahlquist.
A little experience there. Dahlquist played very well in the JV game, but this is a little bit different speed here with that veteran move by Shepard inside, getting that offensive rebound and getting the and one, too.
Uses his body really well, did Shepard that time. He comes out of the game, and Quarter comes back in.
With the Trojans,
minute 26 to play in the third quarter. Triton by 21. The Zebras of the basketball going to our right.
Shepard's got 17. Four are from the free throw line.
Noah Dahlquist, 10-footer, is off the mark, no good. And Quarter the rebound. How many in doubles right now for Triton?
Two.
Sellers, left baseline, one dribble. Has his pass tipped away and stolen by Abbott. Abbott goes in for the shot, no good. Tough shot, and the rebound comes down to Triton.
I think he was expecting contact, and that's the play where the defender did the Olay play. Makes you think he's going to come in and bang you on and backs off, and Brett didn't have time to adjust.
Sellers kicks it out to a wide-open Yo for three. Nope, short. Rebound tipped out. Gives to Harrell with 40. Now Quarter holds in the center circle against Gehrig. High on the left side to Seller with 35. Sellers, couple of dribbles to the right, in the middle of the floor, switches directions down the center circle. Got to get rid of it. That's going to be a 5-second count, but he just does get it.
For whatever reason, the referee gave up the count.
Yeah.
He wasn't going anywhere.
Anderson against Holland with 15. Right side to Harrell with 14. Bounce pass to Sellers with 12. Now back to Yo with 10. Gives to Anderson with 9. Drives the left wing. Looks back door. Oh, fortunately for the Zebras, Holland's going to commit a foul because that backdoor pass to Yo was wide open.
Foul's going to be, you're right, on Alec Holland on the reach on the pass. He slapped across the wrist as the man was trying to make a pass. But you're right, that was a good offense again. Was going to be a wide open backdoor cut.
7.2 to play in the third. Right by 21, they'll have the last shot of the period.
Wondering when we're going to see that. I mean, that's the danger of Triton. They're so good on the three-point line that you know they got to have backdoor cuts in their arsenal.
Yo drives, kicks it out. Three on the way with two. It's short and off the top of the backboard and no good. After three, Triton leads 51-30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Fourth quarter we go. The Rochester Zebras trailing Triton by 21 at 51-30. Now, after the first quarter, Rochester was up 20-15. Since then, Rochester scored 10 points in the second and third quarters. Two in the second and eight in the third.
Sometimes the worst thing that can happen to you is end of the quarter. I mean, they had everything going.
Yeah.
You know, it sounds simple, and people don't believe that, but, I mean, the flow of the game, you know, it's only a minute, but, and I think the way this team goes, especially after just having that happen to them, a 20-point and a 2-point quarter, you're sometimes your own worst enemy that's almost like, oh, here it goes again.
Yeah.
You know, here's that drought. Sometimes the mental hurdles are the toughest to overcome.
And you just said Triton's being faced by two 17ers?
Yeah, Shepard and Reichert each have 17.
Anderson down low to Quarter. Quarter drives against Kennedy. Kennedy alters the shot, rebound to Gehrig. Rochester runs down by 21. Kennedy top to Holland. Holland against Anderson, gets a pick, works the left side. Down to Gehrig. Kerrigan left baseline against Sellers. Drives it hard to the basket. Throws up a shot. It's good. And that was a determined drive right there. He got it to go for another two.
13 for Gehrig.
Two and doubles now for Rochester. Unfortunately, two of those have almost equals 30. And Anderson got a circus shot to go in, and he's fouled by doing so. He'll go to the line to shoot one.
That young man has eight now.
He came off the bench for Triton.
Triton, perfect 17 of 17 from the free throw line.
Wow. Anderson has one. And it is good.
Make it 18 for 18.
22-point lead for Triton, the biggest of the night, with a minute gone in the fourth quarter. Garrett drives it right. Leaner off the window is no good. Kennedy the rebound. His putback on the way is no good, but a foul coming on Triton, and Kennedy will go to the line to shoot two.
Kennedy again trying to break in the scoring column tonight. Has not yet done so. Fouls on number 22, Austin Sellers, his second, team third.
Good things happen when you get in the paint.
Yep, getting the paint, getting offensive putback. There's a lot of things that can happen when you get down there.
Luke's first one's good.
Yeah, he's a good free throw shooter. That's the other thing. You know, it's not like you're a post player with poor touch.
Yeah.
There's a lot of post players make a big living off the free throw line just hanging around down there. Remember, like Carl Malone, it seemed like, that, you know, just you work and it's amazing what you can find when you work hard underneath the bucket.
Yeah, right. 6:59 to play in the game. Kennedy with one more free throw. Second one by the seniors, good again as it rattles in. Triton up by 20 here at Rochester High School. Harrell on the right side for Triton against the double team, and now we're going to have a foul by Holland on the reach-in, and that's going to send Triton to the line for one in the bonus.
It's going to be Holland's third, team's seventh. And like you said, Triton will be shooting the rest of the way, which is not what you want to do when a team's 17 or 18 for 18 from the line.
So Screeton comes in, and Holland will have a seat with three fouls.
Actually, four. Must have missed one. We've got Holland for four.
Free throw by Harrell is good. He'll have one more. Triton, 19 free throw attempts tonight.
19 make.
I was wondering if that was going to come. Second one is in and out, no good.
Hey,
good rebound to Kennedy. Quickly head to Abbott. Abbott drives, runs over Riker, no call. Leaner on the way from 5 feet is good.
Nice job. Really be patient.
Riker across the timeline left, over the top of the defense to Yo. Yo throws it away, can't pass it. Camp will go in for the right-handed layup. It's good. Timeout, Triton. It's a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
6:24 to play in the game. Triton up 55-38, and after the Triton timeout, they've got the basketball going to our left. Riker across the timeline. Gives to Shepard, who's had a big game for Triton. Back to Riker. Midway on the baseline, top of the key to Sellers. Looks at the three, drives it, throws up a shot, blocked by Kennedy. He has the rebound. He gives it head to Gehrig. Gehrig, left side of the floor, gives to Camp for three. Left baseline is good.
Number two.
Spark here in the fourth quarter for the Zebras. That's 11 points after scoring 10 in the second and third quarters combined.
Right on. 55-41 Triton. 5:45 to play in the game. No look pass down low to Midway. Gives him the corner to wide open Reichert. His three is short. And now ahead to Kennedy. Kennedy gives it to Camp. Camp, no look pass to Streeton.
Nice
Streeton, leaner off the window is good. Timeout Triton. Rochester's cut this lead to 12. It's a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Just as coaches and team players need to have excellent communication skills to win games, so do you when it comes to all of your telecommunication needs. At RTC, they strive to bring you the very latest technology when it comes to telephone, high-speed internet, and cable television. Call them at 223-2191 and ask to speak with one of their knowledgeable, helpful, and local customer service representatives. RTC, local products, local support, local investment.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
5.5 minutes to play in the game. Rochester's got this lead down to 12 as they trail Triton right now 55-43. And after the Triton timeout, they'll have it going to our left. Riker gets it in to Harrell and now gives off to Anderson. Gives ahead to Riker over the top of the defense to Harrell. Has it high on the right side to Anderson. Swings the left side to Riker. Rochester in a 2-3 zone, extended out to the volleyball line. To Anderson, quickly to Shepherd. Floater in the lane is no good. Garrick rips the board and runs. Garrick, left side of the floor. Garrick goes all the way to the basket. Finger roll off the front of the rim is good. And now Rochester has this lead down to 10.
Zebras, a couple things they've done well. They've rebounded really, really well. They limited Triton to one shot, and they've looked the ball and pushed the ball off the floor when they've gotten those rebounds.
Shepherd in the paint. Shot blocked. Garrick has it. Garrick, middle of the floor. Got away with a carry. Layup is good. Rochester has a lead down to 8. It's 55-47. Here come the Zebras. Harrell around the defense to Anderson over the top. Back to Harrell. High on the right side for Triton. 4:35 to play in the game. Rochester down by 8. Triton's going to be called for, well, he should have been called for a foul that far sideline, but the Trojans will use a timeout. It will be a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. Basketball, swimming, and wrestling are going strong, and the Winter Olympics are here. Go USA! There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, outdoor activity, or getting together with family and friends, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4.5 to play in the game. Rochester has cut this 22-point lead down to 8, and still with plenty of time here to keep climbing. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. It was a rough second and third quarter, but Rochester playing well in the fourth.
Yeah, absolutely, and this student section just hasn't figured it out yet. Poor kids. Man, I mean, I'll tell you what. These guys have fought, scratched, clawed, and everybody in this gym, it's like they're watching cricket on the Sunday lawn in London. I mean, man, this has been a great comeback. Russ Howell figures out these kids are bad on fight. Really, in the big scheme of things, you know, there's not a lot to gain, but they're still fighting and working hard.
You think
the crowd would respond to that. This is the biggest frustration thing that I've got going around here is these kids are selling out and working really hard, and it's just like nobody's even here.
Kennedy is going to be called for a foul. That's going to send Quarter to the line to shoot one of the bonus for Triton. Looking to push this lead back to 10.
That's Luke's fourth, team's eighth.
Well, unfortunately, stays. The kid only know what they see.
True. But, you know, we saw it in the section with John Glenn in their student section. And, you know, it's around in pockets. I mean, look at even Triton. Triton, at least their kids are standing up. I mean, they might only have 20 kids over there or so, but at least they're here and standing up. I mean, that's, you know, I don't know. I'm not sure what the answer is, but.
I'm with you. I agree. Quarter makes 2 free throws, and the lead is back to 10 with 4:15 to play in the game. Garrick, top of the key, picks up his dribble, gives to Streeton. Holland still on the bench for Rochester. Kennedy with 4 personal fouls now. Basham high on the left side. Down low to Kennedy. Luke out to Garrick. Three, right wing. Oh, way off the mark. Quarter with the rebound, and he is fouled by Streeton.
It's going to be Streeton second. Seaver's ninth. So shooting free throws here again. And let's see. Quarter's going to the line where he made his last two. He's got 6 points. He's 2 for 2 from the line.
Under 4 to play in the game. A 10-point lead for Triton. Holland will come back in after this free throw. And it's good by Quarter. He'll have one more.
Like you said, they've only missed one. I think it makes 20 for 21 from the line for Triton at this point.
One more coming for Quarter. With this free throw, he can push the lead to 12, and he does so. 59-47, Triton. Street with the basketball.
These receivers can't keep getting something inside. Drives and post feeds.
Street holds high on the left side against the man-to-man defense. Gets a pick from Basham. Runs to the free throw line. Throws up a shot. In and out. No good. A lot of contact. No foul. And Quarter at the board. Quarter runs. Picks up the dribble. Top of the key. Outside to Anderson. Anderson drives it right side to Rickett. No, Reichert, I believe beg your pardon.
Reichert.
Yep, that too. To Shepherd. He's had a big three night behind the three-point line.
Trying to demonstrate some patience here, especially against this zone. Going to move the basketball. Make the Zebras come out, play a little aggressive with 3:12 left. Up
yeah,
12.
Yeah, I was going to say, they're up 12.
Zebras got a little 1-3-1 look. Kind of a trap. Not completely selling out yet at this point. So, going to have to at some point.
Yep.
You don't necessarily want to have to get in a situation where you got a foul. You'd like to try to get some steals, whereas Kennedy gets one.
But throws it right into the hands of Anderson, trying to save him from going out of bounds. 2:50 to play in the game.
Going to try to start gambling. And I mean, it's, you know where their help's going to be. Try to start reading some eyes and try to gamble and play some passing lanes.
Reichert 0 for 3 for Triton. Why not? Good
heavens. Number 33.
62-47, 2.5 to play in the game.
That's his 6-3.
Garrick, the basketball, drives it right hard. Throws up a shot over the defense. Off the window and good. 62-49.
He's got 19.
Shepherd around the defense. Picks up his dribble. Wide open his Quarter. He throws over the top of the defense to Anderson, top of the key. Now high on the left side to Shepherd, and 2 to play in the game.
I think 19 to be Garrick's career high, wouldn't you guess?
I would guess that, yep. Boy, Quarter drives it, throws up a shot, no good, gets his own rebound. The putback on the window is good, and a foul.
Number 4, Jody Quarter.
That foul's going to be on Basham, his third, Zebra's 10th, so it's 2 shots the rest of the way.
Checking in for the Zebras.
Quarter joins the double figures club with 10. So Shepard's got 17. Reichert's got 20. Quarter now has 10.
And Rochester will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Fulton County Best One Tire is so much more than just tires. They offer a complete line of service with quality you can depend on. Ask their friendly staff about an oil change, transmission flush, brake service, alignment, or even an engine replacement. Or stop by and see their experts about a custom exhaust. They also keep the area's largest tire inventory in stock. Right now, you can take advantage of great rebate programs. Just call Doug or Todd at 223-2103. Fulton County Best One Tire, where the most important person to them is you. They're located at the corner of Fort Wayne Road and Highway 25 North in Rochester.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
A minute 50 to play in the game, 64-49. line. Triton leads, and at the free throw line is Quarter for one more. Is that right? And it's short, and the rebound to Kennedy. Triton has shot the ball, what, 21 or two times tonight and missed two of them?
They're 23 of 25 from the free throw line.
Wow. And own a 64-49 lead. And Abbott in the lane.
And they've hit nine threes.
Yeah, that helps. Kennedy for threes, and no good. Rebound fall four, and Midway comes out of it with it. Ahead to Quarter, right-handed layup on the window, good, and a foul. How many threes?
Nine.
Five of those have come from Reichert.
Yeah.
Or six.
Yeah.
Number two, Preston Kendall. That's fine. Shooting one.
Quarter has 12. Anderson's almost in the double-figure club. He's got nine. That would give Triton four in doubles. It looks like they're going to clear the bench.
Free throw for Quarter is good as he completes the three-point play. And pushes this lead back to 18. And
line change.
Yep, I was going to say, Coach Groves will bring the starters off the floor. Well, most of them.
I guess they'd probably have a Friday night game as well.
You know, minute I think Valley left. Friday night.
Okay.
Maybe that's, yeah.
That'd be a really good game.
So Rochester with the basketball, a minute 10 to play in the game. Rochester down by 18 now. Lob pass inside is taken away and stolen by Triton. And Yo with it now for Triton. Back to Flinter. Flinter head to Harrell. Harrell back to Flinter, loses the handle, picked up by Garrig with 50. To Abbott. Abbott back to the way in, throws it to Holland. He'll fire a three right wings, in and out, no good. And Sellers with the rebound, and he is going to be fouled by Camp.
Well, for those of you thinking about maybe watching the IU game coming up here at a 9 o'clock start, not going to happen. Roof problems at Assembly Hall. Iowa-Indiana game has been postponed. No makeup date. Got to get the roof fixed. So in the meantime, IU's probably going to be looking to play a couple home games somewhere else. I don't know how quick they could get that.
Yeah. So at the free throw line is Sellers. He makes the first one, looking to push us back to a 20-point lead.
Other games, not surprising. Winamac playing tonight. They've got a game, I think, the rest of the way out, trying to catch up on their schedule. They leading Frontiers 43-34 end of the third.
Second for Sellers is good again. 69-49, 45 to play in the game. Garrig makes it right, loses the handle, picked up by Yo. Yo ahead for Triton, gives down low to a wide open Wanamaker, and his layup is good. 71-49. Holland, left wing in the corner to Kennedy, drives the baseline. Reverse layup is in and out, no good. And the rebound to Yo, and Kennedy's going to pick up foul number five. Okay, right there is what we saw that we need to see the rest of the year. Kennedy took the ball from behind the arc in the left baseline and drove it hard to the basket and tried to reverse layup. I'm good with that.
Yeah, put the ball on the floor, tried to make a play inside, and a great screen by Garrick to kind of get him some space. Unfortunately, as we've seen maybe far too much as well, you're frustrated, so you missed a shot, you got four fouls, and you have a blatant foul that fouls you out of the game. You know, there's too many of those that occur as well. I understand you're trying to make a play, but, you know, don't give up a cheap foul there because you missed a shot. I mean, I know it doesn't mean a whole lot now because there's 21 seconds to go and even foul out, but, you know, there's been some careless fouls. You put yourself and the team in a bad spot by getting those careless fouls.
Whoa, two consecutive misses. Holland for three, left corner off the back of the rim, no good. And Abbott with rebound with 12. Abbott gives to a cutting Garrick, goes to the basket, off the window, nope. Rebound to Yo. Yo with four. Loses to Holland with three. Holland with two. Holland. Three at the buzzer on the way. No good. 71-49 is your final. Triton defeats the Zebras. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI.